And now let's click on download now. And now we can see the events are already getting tracked. So with this, we are not just tracking the number of visitors on our website, we are getting the data of actual leads that are generated on our WordPress website. And this is a pretty powerful data for any business. In this video, we are going to take a look at how we can do event tracking using Google Analytics 4 and the Plus add-ons for Elementor. So let's dive in our WordPress backend and let's get started. So here we are in our WordPress backend, and if we go in the plugin section, here we have the Plus add-ons for Elementor Free as well as Pro version. And once we have installed both of these plugins, we can now go to Plus settings and then go to Plus widgets. And let's search for Event Tracker. So here we have Event Tracker widget, which we are going to use. And as we can see, it's part of the Pro plan of this plugin. So make sure you have the Pro version of Plus add-ons for Elementor installed and activated. And once that is done, we just need to turn on this widget and then click on save. Along with that, we also need to make sure that we have set up Google Analytics 4 in our WordPress website. And you can do that as well in the settings of Plus add-ons. So here, if we go in the extra options, here we can find the GA4 measurement ID. So we are going to paste that ID here and then just need to click on save. Now where I can find my measurement ID, you need to log in your Google Analytics account and make sure you have set up Google Analytics 4 for this website. And now just click on admin and then go to data streams, and you will find all the data streams for your setup here. And if you click on this, here you will find your measurement ID. So let's just copy from here and then we can paste it in the measurement ID column here. Now, if in case you are using any other plugin or by any other way to add this measurement ID in your WordPress website, then you don't have to enter the GA4 ID here. You can skip that part. Like if in case you are using Google Tag Manager, so you don't have to enter the measurement ID here. And this event tracker from the Plus add-ons do work seamlessly with Google Tag Manager as well. And once that is done, here we have a sample landing page for which we want to do our event tracking. So here with this landing page, we want to track how many people actually clicked on this download now button. And this is actually linked to a PDF file. So let's say we want to track how many people actually clicked on this button to download this PDF. And if you come back here in the backend, this page is designed using Elementor. So if you click on this button, here in the link, we have given the link for our PDF. And now to add our event tracking on this, we need to go to Advanced. And here at the bottom, we have Plus Extra Event Tracker. Let's click on this. And here we have Facebook Pixel as well as Google Analytics 4. So right now we have enabled Google Analytics 4 only. We already have a separate video for Facebook Pixel event tracking. You can get the link for that video in the I button above or in the video description below. But right now, let's concentrate on GA4 tracking only. So we will enable that from here. And now we have the event type. So if we click on this, we have recommended as well as custom. Now recommended are the predefined events that we already have in Google Analytics. So if you want to track add to cart in case of an e-commerce website, so you can do that from here. Now, if we check the Google Analytics 4 support documents, here for GA4 recommended events, we can see all the events listed here. Like for an e-commerce site, we have add payment info, add to cart, purchase. So all these events are for Google Analytics 4. If you want to learn more about all these recommended events in GA4, we will leave a link for this article in the video description below. So you can go ahead and take a look at that. But if in case you want to do some custom tracking, so here we have the custom option, we enable that and we name this as downloads, and below this we can define the property of this downloads event name. So let's say we rename this to guide download so that we can have a unique event name. Now below this we have event properties, and here if we click on this, we have given the name for the property as language, and we have given the value as English. So whenever someone clicks on this download button, it's going to download that PDF, and with this event property, we will be able to measure the language as English. So if in case you have different pages on which you are offering this free guide in different language, so you can easily track which PDF is actually getting downloaded. Is it the one in English or anyone else? Along with that, you can add more item in this event property to have a deeper tracking. For example, if we click on add item, here we can give the name as price and we will give this as value free. So along with the language, that is English in this case, we will be able to get the details about the price, which is free in this case. Now once again, if you have a free file or a paid one, then you can easily track which one is getting downloaded from here. Now if you come back here in the GA4 support documents, we have a document for automatically collected events. And if we scroll down, we can see we already have a file download event. And if you are offering any document, text or any audio or video file, which is the most common form of files that you might be offering on your site, so this event is automatically getting tracked in GA4. So the question is, what is the purpose of the plus add-ons here? And that is the point where event property comes in. By default, every download is getting under the file download event. But with the help of plus add-ons, you will be able to know, is it the one which is in English language or any other language? Or is it the free one or the paid one? So with the plus add-ons, you will be able to know the exact data what people are downloading on your WordPress website. And once we are done, we can go to publish to publish this page. And if we open this page in the front end, in the real-time tracking, we can see we have a one visitor on our website, and that is on our landing page. And if we go in events here under examine user behavior, we have the list of all the events happening on this website. So here we can see we have the event of page views, scroll, user engagement, session start, and we have download and file download event as well. So let's say we click on this download now button here, and it's going to open up our PDF file. And if you come back here in the event section, it might not show you the data instantly. It takes around 24 hours to see all the data here. So there are a lot of factors that can affect the data here. But in order to check if we have implemented the event tracker correctly or not, we have a solution for that. We are going to use a Chrome extension for this. And this extension will help us track all the events happening on our WordPress website. So we go to Chrome Web Store. And here we search for Google Analytics. And here we have an extension called Google Analytics Debugger. If you click on that, you will find an install button here. I have already installed it, so that's why I see this remove from Chrome button. So in order to install it, all you have to do is just click on the install button here. And once you install this extension, you will find the icon for the extension here on the top bar. And if you click on this, it will turn on this debugger. So if you mouse over here, we can see it's on. And now if you go back in our Google Analytics, let's go to admin again. And here for the property, if we scroll down, we have an entry. It says debug view. Let's click on this. And now we can see our website events happening in real time. So let's go ahead and refresh our page again. And let's try to download the PDF once again and see if that gets tracked here. So let's load this page again. And now let's click on download now. It's open up our PDF. Now let's go back to our Google Analytics. So in our debug view, we can see we have a page view. We got a session start, and then we have recorded a guide download event, which is the name of the event that we have given here. And that comes under the file download. If you click on this, we can see we have two parameters, language as well as price. And once again, we have the same parameter set here. In item 1, we have language, and in item 2, we have price. And that's the same parameters we see here. If you click on this, we got the value as English. And if we click on this, we got the parameter as free. which means whatever information we have entered here, it's actually getting tracked and stored in our Google Analytics 4. Now, one thing we need to make sure is that we do not have any active ad blocker in our Chrome browser. So if you are using any ad blocker extension, please disable that before using this analytics debugger. Now, instead of this download button, you might have a contact form or a lead form, so you can implement the same event tracker on that as well. So instead of doing event tracking on this button, all you have to do is just add the event tracking on the form submit button. So this is how we can implement event tracking on our WordPress website with the help of Google Analytics 4 and the plus add-ons for Elementor. If you like this video, then make sure you give it a like and make sure you watch this video right here to learn more about how you can use the plus add-ons for Elementor to create better WordPress websites. And to watch more videos like this, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit that notification bell so that you can get notified whenever we upload our next video. That's it for this one, and I'll see you in the next video.